Welcome. Myself, Mr. V.V.Anagire, Assistant Professor, Department of Electronics and Telecommunication, Walchand Institute of Technology. Today we are going to study communication technology for IoT, and that is NFC. Learning outcome: at the end of this session, students will be able to explain working principle of NFC. Before starting with NFC, student should recall what is wireless sensor networks. Now we'll start with what is NFC. So NFC stands for near field communication. As you can see in this diagram, that NFC is to be used for identification of the tags, time attendance, physical access, secure PC login, transit, cashless payment, loyalty and memberships, and ticketing. For these many things, you can use NFC. So generally, near field communication technology is a wireless technology, which is similar to Bluetooth, but thing it's instead of using radio frequencies, radio waves, as well as electromagnetic induction principle is to be used to send as well as receive data in NFC. In NFC, frequency range used is 13.56 megahertz, and data transfer rate is 424 kbps. So generally, in case of NFC, the data is to be transferred from one device to another device, and there should be one transmitter and another one should be a receiver. Now we'll see working of NFC. So electromagnetic induction principle is used in NFC to send the data or receive the data. So in electromagnetic induction, when EMF is induced in the primary of a coil, then EMF is induced in secondary also. So this particular concept is to be used to send as well as to receive the data. So generally, when two devices want to communicate with each other, you can use two different types of NFC technologies to transmit or receive the data. So if we are using the passive tags, so in that case it does not require a power, because other device is powered and it can activate, or the EMF is to be induced in passive tag because of active tags. So in case of active tags, means if both the devices are enabled with active tags, that time data is to be sent or received with the help of those active tags. In case of passive tags, data is to be just transmitted by that passive tag, means data is to be just read. Two-way communication is not there in passive tags. So NFC will use technology similar to RFID, that is radio frequency identification. So just like RFID tags, there are NFC tags through which the communication is to be done. Now we'll see type of NFC tags. First one is passive tags, and second one is active or peer-to-peer tags. So in case of passive tags, there are many interactive tags which are mounted on a wall or advertisements. So you can read those passive tags with the help of your smartphones, and you can read the information. So in case of passive tag, it does not require power, because those smartphone which work as active tags can induce EMF in those passive tags. So second one is active or peer-to-peer tags. So smartphones, public transport card readers, as well as touch payments, these are the example of active or peer-to-peer tags. So two smartphones can communicate with each other, and those work like active tags. So the thing is, just we have to turn on the NFC in both the smartphones. So NFC chip is available in the smartphones to communicate with the help of NFC. So when we turn on that NFC in the smartphones, and when those two smartphones will interact with each other, the data is transferred. And the restriction on the NFC is a small amount of data is to be transferred, because of the data transfer is of 424 kbps, and distance between those two devices is very much small, means range of NFC is limited to just 20 centimeters, and practically it is up to 10 centimeters. So NFC is to be used for short range communication, we can say. Now we'll see NFC versus Bluetooth technology. So generally NFC is better in some manner as we compared it with the Bluetooth technology. And in some manner there are some drawbacks of NFC technology. NFC will require very small amount of power or less power as compared to Bluetooth technology. As well as in case of near field communication, two devices are to be paired in very small amount of time as compared to Bluetooth technology. But there are some drawbacks of NFC, as NFC is to be used for short range communication. Like distance between two devices should be 10 centimeter, but in case of Bluetooth technology, the range is of 50 meters. As well as data transfer. So data transfer rate for NFC is 424 kbps, but in case of Bluetooth technology, it is up to 3 mbps. So in some manner, NFC is better than Bluetooth technology. So if we consider security factor, NFC is much secure than Bluetooth technology, because in case of NFC, if someone want to hack the data, the particular device should be very much near to your smartphone. So it will not happen, or it is not possible to hack the data in case of NFC, as well as higher level security is to be provided in NFC technology as compared with Bluetooth. But newest form of Bluetooth technology, which is called as Bluetooth 4.0, is much more faster than NFC, we can say. Next, we will see applications of NFC. First one is Bluetooth payments. So now these days, NFC technology is to be used for mobile payments. So generally payments are to be done in malls as well as shops with the help of smartphones. So a particular app is to be installed in your smartphone, which will enable NFC. So with the help of that app, payment is to be done with the help of smartphone. Next application is Google Wallet. So Google has developed its own NFC enabled payment system, which is called as a Google Wallet. So presently in US, research is going on this particular application, that is Google Wallet. So with the help of Google Wallet, you can make a payment, and debit cards, credit cards, as well as gift cards are also be accessed with the help of Google Wallet. Next application is PayPal. So similar to Google Wallet, PayPal is also developed a particular app which will work like similar to that PayPal. Another app or application is Square. So it is also coming up with a dongle which is to be connected with the smartphone, which enables payments. Next one is ISIS. So this application is also used to perform payments in case of malls as well as shops. And last one is other NFC uses. So we can connect NFC chips or passive NFC tags in your cars, homes, or anywhere, and the particular devices are to be controlled with the help of near-field communication. So generally, NFC is used for payments, but in some case, or now these days, as technology is moved up, NFC is to be used for some other applications also. So NFC it's very much secure in case of other wireless technologies, but the thing is NFC is to be used for short range communication, and it works like a RFID tag. So while preparing this video lecture, I have used Internet of Things Architecture and Design Principles by Rajkamal and Internet of Things for Architects by Perilli. Thank you.